got to say about that. What's going on, everybody? What's up? What's up? It's Martin Monday Mayhem. Well, on this side of the world, I think on the other side of the world, it's Martin Tuesday Mayhem. So what's going on, guys? Oh, yes. Here I am again. Here I am again having to call out a fucking spineless coward, Martin fucking Dehan. You know what, Martin? Yeah, scuttled off pretty fucking quickly back to Norway. You know, as soon as you got home, what do you do? Start fucking, first thing you did is make a community post about AD. You know, you have a fucking lot of explaining to do, Martin Dehan, or whoever the fuck you are, in regards to all of your fuckery, which none of this is being dispelled. For example, your overall aggressive, threatening, intimidating demeanor towards women. Myself, Salty, Bam, many of my subs. Your ridiculous, careless, often at times dangerous information that you've thrown out as fact with absolutely zero to back up your preposterous claims. All of your massive inconsistencies that you've never once apologized or taken any accountability for because you're a fucking loser, spineless coward who runs away and disappears. All your contradictory bullshit about, oh, I don't know, Claire, the non-lawyering liar. The fact that you said you hired Duncan Lewis to sue fucking armchair detective. Punking us all with the Ofcom bullshit. That's just a few things that I'm going to kind of start and mention. And you know what? First things fucking first, Martin. What the fuck? You are such a lying, fucking shriveled up ball sack piece of shit. Salty and I have never, ever, 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 ever body shamed, called Helen a fucking prostitute, a whore. No, 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 no. And you know what I gotta say about fucking that? We're not gonna take it. No, we ain't gonna take it. Oh, we're not gonna take it anymore. You're a fucking piece of shit, Martin. Not a fucking chance in hell that you are going to try to discredit me, try to ruin my reputation with your fucking bullshit lies. Absolutely never gonna fucking happen, you fucking spineless fucking piece of shit. This is what I'm talking about right here, guys. Just a second there to make it bigger. Fuck you, Martin, you fucking lying sack of fucking shit. And you know what the best part of this is, guys? Hang on. Oh, that was just a little too big.
You can tell that a lot of these true crime YouTubers, they've never thought for themselves in their entire life. You are like those dumbass puppies, you know, the ones that run around with their tongue hanging out of their mouth cross-eyed. You know, the puppy's cute, but it's still fucking stupid, you know?
And that's kind of what I'm thinking about. All of you people still over there supporting fucking Martin and Helen Chafer. This is fucking bullshit. And not a fucking chance in hell, Martin spineless fucking shriveled up ball sack coward Dehan. Am I ever going to be fucking threatened or intimidated by you? Nor am I going to let you fucking try to pull bullshit like this. I mean, this just compiles on top of all the other bullshit that you've already tried to spread across this fucking whole community, what's left of it, after you and your friend fucking Claire, non-lawyering liar Morgan, destroyed it. So this was, guys, from, so those of you that don't know, yesterday, Chuffs decided that she needed to put out two warm-up videos to make a big production of her actual live stream she did yesterday. Martin also put out a video because two previous warm-up videos weren't enough. Let's do three. And nowhere in either the two videos that Chafer did before her stream, the video that Martin did of Helen's stream that was upcoming, or in Helen's fucking stream, period, did Minor Salty's name ever come up accusing us of saying this fucking bullshit. And you know what Martin did? He tried to make more chaos with this fucking comment that he buried. This outlandish, absolutely 1,000% false comment. He buried it deep within his own video comment section. Now, why would you do that? Why wouldn't you have said that in your video? Why wouldn't you guys have called like, fuck off, you know damn well it's not fucking true. And you know what? You, Martin. I don't know who the fuck you are or who the hell you think you are, but I'm not fucking, not a fucking chance in hell. You want to try to ruin me? I'm going to come back for you fucking 10,000 fucking times as hard, Martin. We're just getting going tonight. I got a few things I want to show some people that I don't think you're going to like too much, but you know what? Too bad. It's your own actions and your own fucking words. Never, ever, ever have Salty and I ever said anything like that about Helen, ever. You fucking lying piece of shit, and you know it. But you're still using your obscure illusions, trying to leave a comment here so that people, oh, I don't know. Well, Martin said it. It must be fucking true. Sorry, guys. I'm not really paying attention to chat tonight. I'm really fucking, I got some things to say to Martin fucking Dehan. Again, you don't learn, do you, idiot? You're a fucking loser. You're a washed up, wannabe, never was, has been fucking rock star. You're a fucking loser. You're a fucking failure at everything. And all you can do is sit behind your computer and make videos attacking people. Women, because you and your contradictory stories about Claire and anybody because they didn't turn around with you. When you decided to, well, whatever decided, you've got contradictory stories all over the fucking place about that. But according to you, you did your 180 degree hard fucking turn on your stance about Claire. Just like AD, we don't follow with you. We ask questions. You attack. No, you don't. Not going to fucking happen, man. Now, give me a sec, guys. I'm going to pull up. So this was the entire conversation that Martin made this comment under. You guys can have a look at that for a moment. Never, ever, ever, ever have I ever, Salty, well, Salty may be on her channel. I know she's had her go at people, but never on my channel. She said, fuck all about Helen. I have never trashed anybody's looks, period. You people all fucking know me. And Martin, the fact that you're trying to push that bullshit so passively aggressively like Helen is. Yeah, I've called Helen passive aggressive. That's nothing like body shaming somebody, making fun of someone's looks. I've never fucking done that. And you fucking know it, but I still fucking am not going to let you get the fuck away with trying to put that out there for people that haven't quite caught on to what a fucking idiot and loser you are, Martin. Not going to let you get away with it. Fucking right. Jesus Christ. I don't know who the fuck, fucking goddamn washed up, wannabe, never was, has been fucking rock star. Since when do people's eyes change from brown to blue anyway? That's what I'd like to know. Give me a sec, guys. It's like 300 degrees. We just had a storm and it cooled down for like, 20 seconds. And now it's like three times as hot again. Oh. I'm also still a bit sunburnt from being outside all day yesterday. So while I leave that up, hey, how is it going to, Obama, how's it going? Anime is here, bedtime clown, Cassius, what's up, Devil Mike? Hip chick, my Joe Madre. Who invited that Kimberly Faith? Get her out of here. No, she can stay, she's my favorite. Larnie, I love you. Oliver, puff pass. What up, Simcast? Sunray and her sexy leg. Tamara, the lady witch bitch. Georgia girl, did I say hi? Anybody else that I've missed coming in and going out, I apologize. I'm Oliver's present and accounted for. EK, Tamara. Sorry, guys. Whoever I'm missing, I apologize. Darzan, I saw you. Yep, exactly. The whole focus is trying to get it off fucking Claire. Not going to fucking happen. Nice try, Martin. Yep, let's point. Oh, but you know what? This online bullying, you haven't been able to get, I don't even want to talk. Bam is very capable of defending herself. But what I am going to say is, Martin, you look like a fucking moron. You and Helen together. I mean, it's very obvious. You don't want to bring my insulties name into it. Because, you know, when we're talking about that non-lawyering liar, Claire. So what you want to try and do is get all the attention onto Bam. What a piece of shit Bam is. Bam's got to be taken off social media. Get a fucking grip. You haven't been able to get AD off. What the hell? People. He's been fucking useless. None of us have been able to get AD off. But now he thinks that creating a petition to get Bam off social media that didn't work for armchair detectives is going to work for Bam? You guys look like fucking fools over there. So you can get fucked, Martin. Fucking saying that Salty and I fucking called Helen a prostitute. Fucking, you are the biggest drama queen I have ever fucking met in my life. And I'm pretty sure, I can't prove it, but pretty sure you've been causing this chaos and mayhem the whole entire time you've been around. All I can prove is what you've done since you decided to support Claire and everybody else after 10 months support Claire, even though there's many stories that you forget you've told in different places that totally contradict the other story you told. But you want us to believe after 10 months you took a hard, fast turn on Claire. Now you support her and everybody else is a piece of shit. Fuck you, Martin. You're the fucking piece of shit. You're a fine, fucking spineless, shriveled up, ball sack, fucking coward. Fucking piece of shit. Give me a sec here. Now, next thing I want to go to. Let's talk about Martin Dehan's latest video, the online bullying that doesn't get armchair detective down, but he thinks that everybody's going to believe it's going to get Bam down. Now, I'm going to put some links in the chat, guys. Give me a couple minutes to get myself sorted out. Talk amongst yourselves if you don't mind. Pretty please. Ba-dum-ba-bum. Cassius, I don't even know if I said hi to you. And definitely hello to everybody that's, obviously I said hi to who I could see in the chat. Those that are just watching, lurking. and especially the haters. And you too, Martin and Helen. Fucking hell, I'm sick of your fucking shit. I've never seen the portal. Claire never lied. Claire has dignity. Claire has held her high up with grace. I've never seen evidence of this portal being shown. You have lied and covered for your best fucking non-lawyering liar friend, Helen, all this time. And somebody made a comment under my latest community post, and I don't have it up in front of me. I apologize to whoever said it that I'm not naming, like shouting your name out, but the comment was gold. Just because you haven't seen it, Helen, doesn't mean it's not true. So you look ridiculous now too with this, Claire's never lied. I don't know what a portal is. I've never seen evidence of it. Claire has been nothing but held herself with grace and dignity. You look like a moron. You really fucking do, Helen. But whatever, keep it up. YouTube lady, I see you. All right, hang on, guys. I'm just putting... All right, I'm trying to do 50 things at once. I don't like Mondays, but if I was in the UK, it would be Tuesday. All right, let's have a little looky at this, guys. So if you guys want to join me, I put the link in the chat. That's the original screenshot from Martin's latest bullshit video. So if you guys can't see it on the screen, you can pull it up. That's his regular, like the original screenshot that I took from his video. Now, where do I start ripping this to shreds, Martin? Actually, hold on. Yeah, your name's John Martinson. So what I find interesting, or I don't know, it could be somebody, I've heard other names going around, but so it looks like, I guess, these particular bank cards, or sorry, debit, or blah, 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 credit card law in Norway. Now, it kind of looks like this has been chewed by a dog. I don't know if that's because of the photoshopping job that Martin has tried to do, or if it's just a mangled credit card that's been through the ringer. This little curve here does actually, the Norway cards, or the, hang on. Of course I didn't grab that screenshot. Larnie, can you, if you don't mind, darling, whatever it was you put into Google, that screenshot you sent me today with that lovely display of cards that showed that little like dip. If you could find that again and put the, I don't know, like a link in the chat, that would be lovely. So anyways, so let's just say this has been eaten by a dog, mangled. First of all, that's pretty white on that writing and your expiry date to make it look like this is a current credit card. Pretty white considering it's, you know, been, I don't know, looks like it's been through the ringer over here. Now, hang on, guys. I'm going to put another link in the chat in a second here. Oh, don't pull up the same thing, Jen. Dun, dun, dun. Martin Dehan is a piece of fucking shit. Liar. All right. So again, this is going to be a different link, guys, for another screenshot entirely. Let's talk about symmetry. Shall we for a minute, guys? Let's talk about symmetry. So what I've done is I've put a straight line. Oh shit, wrong one. I've put a straight line under the name. Now, if you guys, by all means, don't believe me, take that original screenshot that I, that the original one that I took from his video, open up some sort of like photo editor, paint, whatever, put your own straight line underneath and see for yourself. Don't believe me, do it yourself. Okay, so there's the screenshot I did of the line I put on under that. I'm not sure if you guys can see. I'm trying to make it big enough so you can see. I have another screenshot of it zoomed in, but oh, that's too big. Can you guys see from that photo? It's clearly not aligned. Martin, you're a fucking idiot. Credit cards are stamped and embossed or engraved by a machine. There is no chance for human error to have a misalignment. Never mind the fact that the white isn't rubbed off anywhere on your credit card, but it doesn't work like that, Martin. Yeah, exactly, EK. Wonky looking, JoJo. Wait, so watch this one. So I don't know how much you can see, even though I zoomed it in. So now I'm going to put a third. And again, don't believe me, guys. Take that first link I put in and put your own line underneath it, and you'll be able to see for yourself. So now I'm going to show a zoomed in one. Like, tell me, fucking come on. Martin, you're fucking pathetic. Fucking pathetic. What a fucking loser you are. Are you fucking kidding me? I mean, that's... guys, all I did, I can see you kind of in the chat probably finding other things wrong with it. I'm sure there is, without a doubt there is. I just want to kind of pointed, we could probably sit here for the next 3 hours tearing this whole thing apart, just the credit card. Yeah, I mean, there's exactly, Joe Madre, the letter size is huge and wonky. There's so much we can rip apart with it, and that's great. I'm glad you guys are seeing the other things that are wrong with it. I just wanted to kind of point out the obvious that no machine would emboss the fucking credit card without it being aligned. So, Martin, you're a fucking piece of shit. Your name is not Martin Dehan. I don't know what you're fucking... I think your real name is John Mortensen. Because do you remember, Martin, that you gave me your credentials to log into Patreon back in 2020? Do you remember that? Probably not. Do you remember the time I made a video because I thought AD kicked you off your tier? So I hadn't been in Patreon for a while. He'd given me his login credentials so I could watch AD's Patreon streams. Well, I went to log in one day, guys. And I went to log in, and sure enough, when I logged in, it brought me to the payment section. And, fuck, it's hot. Sure enough, the payment section was looking for, it needed to process the credit card. The credit card was rejected. Whether I thought at the time Alan had kicked him off the $5 tier and was going to force him to re-sign up under the $10 tier. I suspect probably there wasn't enough funds on the card, but it doesn't matter. That card was in the name of John Mortensen, not Martin Dehan. That credit card had the name John Mortensen on it, and that was the name that Martin Dehan was using in Patreon because that was the name on the credit card. So fuck you, Martin. Give me a sec, guys. Okay, yeah, I saw what you sent me. I don't have time to look at it right now, Christine. Thank you. I mean, Larnie, thank you. I'm not focusing on Claire all that much right now. I'm trying to keep it with Martin and his pieces of fucking bullshit. Give me a sec. It's really fucking hot in here. Will the real Martin Dehan please stand up? I don't think he exists. And again, guys, since when does someone's eyes go from brown to blue? Could somebody answer me that? Do brown eyes change to blue as you grow older? I think that's a fair question. No, John Mortensen is not the lead singer from the Yum Yums. He's got a different name. I can't think of it right now. Martin Henriksen is his name, is the lead singer. I can see how it would get confused with John Mortensen. Adam Kara, this is his name. Morten Henriksen is the lead singer of the Yum Yums. Don't it make my brown eyes blue? That's why Crystal Gayle. That's why Crystal Gayle wrote that song. Just for you, Martin Dehan, John fucking Mortensen, whoever the fuck you are. All right, so. Next thing we're going to talk about. Actually, before I do that, I want to remind everybody about the bullshit Martin punking us about Ofcom. So the whole thing was a farce. Ofcom, their intention of regulating video sharing platform providers they never had the intention of regulating video sharing platforms in those that are in the United States jurisdictions. Not at this point, anyway. Ofcom's sole focus and goal is regulating video sharing platforms in the United Kingdom jurisdictions only. So let's remind everybody, here's a little video that shows that proves Martin's fucking full of shit. He punked us all and took us all for fools.
We'll be right back. a sad song for you on the world's smallest violin.
This is serious.
I know. This really is the world's smallest violin. See?
We're now living in a society where it is okay to be stupid. I don't think it's ever okay to be stupid, because stupid things might happen, and to fix those stupid situations, it needs people who, you know, aren't stupid. Now, the people out there that don't like me and get irritated by me and stuff, I know what you're probably thinking. You're probably thinking, well, why the fuck you think you're so smart? It's actually the problem. I don't think I'm smart at all, but I'm starting to feel smart. I'll never understand, dude. Like, it's a common sense thing. What am I arguing with these other people for? The people I'm arguing with aren't smart enough to understand what's in front of their face. Literally, in front of their face. Yeah, the actual definition of literally. Not using it every other sentence.
Yep, the common sense. Not bothering to try to convince any of those freaks that want to continue. If you want to continue to support Martin and fucking Schaefer's fucking bullshit and lies, by all means, go right ahead. I can't force people to see the truth. They either don't want to see it or are choosing to pretend that's not the case because they like being part of the fucking bullshit. So, I'm talking to fucking Martin cocksucking shriveled up ball sack D-head because fuck you, Martin. How fucking dare you, again, try to continue to ruin my reputation? No. Not going to fucking happen. Every time you want to lie about me, I'm going to expose the fucking truth about you, you piece of fucking shit. Thank you, Emerald Kimmy. YouTube is United States of America based, not United Kingdom based. Ofcom doesn't regulate them for that reason. So don't let anyone, especially Martin cocksucking Dehan, that was my ad lib. Sorry, Emerald Kimmy. Don't let anyone scare you into thinking they do, because they don't. So Martin fucking just pulled the wool over everybody's eyes for somebody that's supposed to be an IT fucking professional. You would think he would have known that. I never fucking looked into anything. I was too busy watching AD and making videos about AD. I didn't bother paying any attention to what Martin was fucking doing until you put the target on your back, Martin, by fucking going after me, going after Salty. You tried to have a go at Simcast. You know what? Simcast may have very well started a friendship with that fucking freak car hobbit, Justin Lee Reacts. But you know what? She realized that it probably wasn't whatever happened. It's over. They're not friends anymore. And you know what? She owned up to it. She took accountability and said, you know what? I fucked up. I made a huge mistake. That shows true integrity and character of a person. Unlike yourself, Martin, who has never owned up for any fucking single mistake you've ever made, let alone apologize. What do? You run away like a fucking goddamn girl and hide because you're a fucking coward. You're a motherfucking spineless coward. Run fucking make videos. Hide behind your computer. You can't take a link. You know, I don't understand. I'm just going to touch upon this quickly. I find it very interesting, Martin and Helen Schaefer. You two had the perfect golden opportunity to make Salty and I look like the biggest fucking fools ever. How come you didn't go live? Why didn't you guys go live? That was your fucking golden fucking nugget right there to once and for all make us look like the biggest fucking chumps ever on YouTube. Shocker, you didn't do it. Shocker. Can't and won't. Yeah. Fuck. I'm just going to go into the comments here, guys. And then we're going to get into the fun stuff. You know, this isn't about AD. AD is still a pervy fraud. I'm not having a go at you, Aboma, but this has nothing to do with AD. I am not going to let Martin trash me, try to discredit me and ruin my reputation. I don't care if you don't like it. I'm not going to let it happen. I have done fucking nothing but expose the fucking truth. Martin doesn't like the fact that people are starting to finally fucking see what a piece of shit he is. And that goes out to all the people that apparently have known what a piece of shit Martin is for a very long time, but were dismissed. But no, this has nothing to do with AD at this fucking point. I am not going to be quiet because of something that AD might be able to use. No, it doesn't fucking work like that as far as I'm concerned. Martin is a piece of shit, and every time he wants to lie about me, I'm going to fucking expose the truth about him. Now, we're going to really get into it. Speaking of exposing the fucking truth. Hang on, guys. AD, well, whatever. You know what? And I'm not having a go at you. I can't even talk tonight. I'm not having a go at you, Aboma. I'm just like, I've had enough with Martin and his bullshit. He thinks that he's going to win a fucking stupid fucking, I'm going to make a video about you and I'm going to fucking discredit you. You're worse than a fucking woman, Martin. You're a fucking loser. You're an absolute loser who's failed at everything. Everything. Yeah, exactly. Thank you. Yeah, defending myself and exposing it has nothing to do with AD at all. At all. And I kind of proved that. Yeah, AD, whatever, tribe made it was thanked me because I called Martin out. That doesn't mean I'm working with AD. AD is not thanking me fucking this week after I exposed his bullshit fake cease and desist. So this has nothing to do with whether AD is winning or not. This is about, again, if we're going to hold armchair fucking pervy fraud detective to a standard, that standard is the backbone of this whole community. You're damn fucking right. I'm going to call out bullshit that's going on when that standard's not being held to that, where we're not, people are not holding themselves to that same standard. And people like Martin Dehan and Claire Morgan have fucking destroyed a fucking community. Goddamn right, I'm going to call that out all fucking day, every day. That's what I got to say about that. All right. Truth is the truth. Yep. End of. Thank you. Thank you, Emerald Kimmy. I like the end there, which is far better. I realize that it may come across as sacrilegious to some, but as far as I'm concerned, it's better to just be honest, which is far better than AD actively discovering this on his own. And it looks like Martin's discovering it too. So you know what? The truth will always come to light. I'm not done, guys. I am far from fucking done. Give me a sec here. Can somebody Photoshop me a credit card so I can go shopping? That would be great. Oh, she did, but Martin has his hand. Haven't quite figured out exactly the full extent of his fuckery, but he's had his hand in it too. No, and I just don't want you to think that I'm having a go at you. Personally, I'm not. I'm just, that's me kind of talking across the board, because I'm not going to let a fucking loser, washed up, has been, never was fucking wannabe rock star, try to fucking intimidate me and think he's going to fucking put me into silence. You don't know me at all. I've said it before. You fucking underestimated me, Martin. You underestimated, you insult my intelligence. You underestimated, you took all of us for fools. It's game fucking over, buddy. You're a fucking piece of shit, and your day is fucking coming. And slowly, all of this stuff, people from the past that have had problems with you that people dismissed, we dismissed, others dismissed, they tried speaking out on their own, but unfortunately, because they were one individual person, their voice obviously wasn't heard. Others have been too scared to talk. Fuck you, Martin. Your reign of fucking terror is over. Motherfucking over. What's up, Foxy in the Boxy? And I saw you, Robert Armour, come sneaking in. Isn't it past your bedtime, darling? Foxy in the boxy. Yeah, we have changed Devil Mike. Apparently, I'm an angry stoner now. Yep, he has. And you know what I'm afraid of? I mean, not afraid of. I'm already seeing it. There's far more than I would have ever imagined. Kind of like with Claire showing people the portal. There's far more many people than we ever imagined that she's shown that portal to. Same thing with Martin. There's far more people that he has attempted to intimidate, maybe has, you know, put into silence. And there's how many are not even have not even said anything yet? Hang on, guys. I just need a drink. It's fucking hot in here. Oh my God. I just downed like 500 milliliters of water. Only my UK and Canadian buddies will understand how much that is. AA. Of course AD is still an ass and a pervy fraud. That goes without saying. All right, so are you guys ready for the good stuff now? So I just want to remind you, Martin, you're not fucking, not a fucking chance in hell. Every fucking time you want to lie about me, I'm going to fucking expose the truth about you. Right, I'm not gonna fucking take it, and neither salty. So your reign of terror is over, Martin. Okay, so now we're gonna get into some fun stuff. Now I am not a big fan of showing private communication. I really am not. Unfortunately, I've had to do it one other time, which is the Claire portal. I normally don't like doing it. However, when it comes into my credibility and my fucking reputation trying to be torn down and shredded, I have to make an exception. And guess what, Martin? I'm making an exception with your bullshit, too, that you emailed to me before you told me to go fuck myself. All right, guys, get ready for this. Get your pen, get your paper. We're going to want to write it down. Well, you know what, Paul Martin, or Martin, Norman, you know, I think, Norman, there may have been some validity, a lot of validity to some of the stuff that he did have to say about Martin. I know Norman is not with us anymore, and I'm not talking ill of the dead. I'm not going down that road, but I just want to say that, you know, again, there very likely was a lot of validity to some of the stuff that he said and he knew about Martin. So we're just going to leave that there as that. Now, they said, get your pens, get your paper, write it down. What's up, SM? Fern, I see you here. Lorac. BTC, I don't know if I said hi to you yet, bedtime clown. Well, if I did, well, hi again. And if I didn't, well, then hi. Ha ha ha. And say hello to your lovely lady, green eyes. I see you snuck in. I'll give Georgia Girl a shout out again. You're going to have to come to Ottawa for Pride next year. It was so much fun yesterday. It was so hot. Hey, hey, hey. Oh my God. That was like Fat Albert.
Hey, hey, hey.
Okay. So, excuse me. We are going to go. I'm not smoking, guys. I'm actually choking because I'm speaking so fast. All right, so this is a little communication. Obviously, I've blocked out my last name. I blocked out my email, and I blocked out Martin's email. So this is going back. I had not heard from Martin. The last time I got an email from him was like, I don't know, sometime in 2020, maybe early 2021. I tried a couple times. I tried emailing him, and as everybody knows, he selectively doesn't Ken says, I blame you, Fern. I'm really sorry. We'll miss you. I know it's gotten to the point. Kent says I blame you. All right, so this was me writing to Martin. May 31st. I know we used to email a while back, and I'm not sure what happened. I just remember a couple of non-replies from you, so I didn't email anymore. I did want to know if the fake-ass cease and desist letter I got would be of assistance to you in whatever course you may be going down. I don't mind if it is going to bury that smug pervert bastard. Now, this is me going on. Remember Martin said that he'd hired Duncan Lewis? Well, that's a load of fucking garbage too, but we'll get to that. We're going to get to that in a minute. One thing at a time. I can only do one thing at a time. All right, so that was my email to him. So let me get back here. Now we're going to, so you guys saw that, right? So I sent that May 31st. What is that? 10:40 in the evening, my time. Martin decides. So May 31st, Martin decides he's going to reply June 2nd. Hi, this was back when I first had eye and ear infection and then the stroke. That's why I couldn't reply on emails. I had difficulty reading, but I'm fine now. Yes, please. I would like as many of those as possible. Since I am, okay, read this, guys. Remember this. Write it down. Write it down, this particular part. Right here. Since I'm in dialogue with his law firm, as soon as I've got the legal documents, I'll forward them to you. I can say this much, though. AD has never been a client of Duncan Lewis. Surprise, surprise, right? So again, we see that was bum, 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 June 2nd. Well, we know that I just proved this past Thursday that Duncan Lewis actually did send those cease and desists. What Alan told Duncan Lewis we were doing that was contained in the cease and desist was bullshit. So the cease and desist being sent from Duncan Lewis actually did come. They really did come from Duncan Lewis. I never received my reply that I sent on October 18th. I tried sending a reply all again the night before I went live. Got a bounce back that Alan's caseworker, Georgina, doesn't even work there anymore. So we know that Alan did have one consultation with Duncan Lewis. So they did send the original cease and desist. All of the what was contained in the cease and desist was all bullshit made up by Alan. Not to mention the whole cease and desist for me is completely nullified because Alan obtained my details, my personal details that he gave to Duncan Lewis to serve me the cease and desist. He obtained those details, my personal details, by deception. He took details that was given to him by YouTube when he false copyright struck me. YouTube gave him my details because I counterclaimed. YouTube gave him my details to serve me with pending litigation, which never happened, kind of like the Claire thing with the strikes. And he took that information that YouTube gave him for the sole only intention of serving me litigation with copyright strikes. He went and he skipped across to Duncan Lewis and gave it to them to send me a cease and desist. That's a big fat no-no. Again, Alan, you're a fucking idiot too. Who the fuck are you to be calling Claire out for breaching data privacy protection when you did the fucking exact same fucking thing, you pervy fraud? Holy fuck, you guys are all fucking hypocrites. Every fucking single one of you. Okay, so now are you guys actually... Before I go to that, I want to show you guys this. So, let me just get it up here. So, Martin wants y'all to believe that he's Richie Rich, Mr. Richie Rich in Norway. Wants y'all to believe that he's hired Duncan Lewis. So, this is from his video, actually. Again, the same video with the fucking Photoshop credit card. So you guys can see that's from his video. What I want to draw your attention to, guys, is this stuff. First of all, Martin Dehan, who apparently seems to underestimate everyone's intelligence, you fucking idiot. You would not be able to, Alan having a consultation, even if it was just one consultation with Duncan Lewis, you would not be able to hire them, you fucking moron. That would be a conflict of interest. You fucking spineless, shriveled up ball sack coward. Duncan Lewis would not allow you to hire them. Even if it was one consultation with Alan, that would be a massive conflict of interest. Now, might I draw your attention here, guys? Two. Martin trying to call out the YouTube lady. I got your back, YouTube lady. You do realize in you trying to call out YouTube lady, once again, you made yourself look like a fucking idiot, loser like you are, Martin. John Mortensen. Let me make this part bigger. This is my favorite part. According to solicitor's code of conduct, your solicitor will be bound by a duty of confidentiality, and he or she should therefore not make any unnecessary disclosures about your case. So I don't believe for one fucking minute, Martin douchebag Dehan, that Duncan Lewis told you anything about Alan. You just know damn well of it that Duncan Lewis actually sent the cease and desist. So no way you can call up Duncan Lewis and say, can I have all the information about Alan Binnicom? They're going to tell you to go fucking fly a kite. So fuck off with your, I'm the richest man in Norway. I'm going to buy Helen a house. I'm going to sue Bam. I'm going to sue Fingal. I'm going to sue everybody that says something bad. And I'm going to sue Alan. Fuck off. You didn't hire Duncan Lewis. One, it would be a conflict of interest for Duncan Lewis to do that. Two, Duncan Lewis, if you even contacted them, which I don't even believe you did, you're just trying to put out your bullshit lies again. Duncan Lewis, what is it called, everybody? Client attorney privilege. They would have disclosed fuck all to a piece of shit nobody, wannabe, rock star, washed up, has been nothing failure. So you can fuck off with that.
You can tell that a lot of these true crime YouTubers, they've never thought for themselves in their entire life. You are like those dumbass puppies, you know, the ones that run around with their tongue hanging out of their mouth cross-eyed. You know, the puppy's cute, but it's still fucking stupid, you know?
Yeah, I am name calling Martin fucking Dehan because you know what? I am not going to be fucking threatened, intimidated, or aggressively attacked by a fucking man. You're damn right I'm name calling Martin. Martin, I will use fucking names and insults with. I have never name called anything. Martin and Alan. Why is it okay, guys? I can call Alan a pervy fraud, but now I say this about Martin and oh my God, too bad. You don't like it? Don't have to listen. Fucking right. Martin and Alan, I will fucking name call fucking men trying to fucking threaten and intimidate women. You're just as bad as Alan is, Martin or John Mortensen. But I have never, ever named, shamed any women, anybody else in this fucking community. So enough with the bullshit about that. Fucking ridiculous. Fucking tired of Martin thinking he fucking runs the fucking goddamn YouTube world. Hang on a sec, guys. Talk amongst yourselves for un momento. I'm going to drop a couple links into the chat about Ofcom. Again, don't fucking believe me. Don't believe me, please. By all means, go and check this shit out for yourself. Don't take my word for it like Martin wants you to do with everything. Brainwashed. Everything I say. Fuck off, Martin. You're fucking done. Fucking sick of your bullshit, thinking you can run around fucking causing mayhem and terror and threatening and fucking intimidating whoever the fuck you want. It ends. It's done. It's over, Martin. You're a fucking piece of shit. Kimberly, I don't know why people think America is just a free-for-all. We do have privacy laws, too. All right, hang on, guys. So now, what I want to show you, this is my favorite part. This is another indiscrepancy that Martin, about Martin and his Claire bullshit. You guys are going to love this one. So we're continuing on with the email trail. So, right, the last one was the fifth. He had fucking had a stroke and this and that. And I fell off my e-scooter. Blah, blah, blah. Hang on while I pull it up. Pull it up, pull it up, pull it up. Up, up. Okay, so got to go bottom to top here. So I sent him a different. Wait, is it bottom to top? Must be. Yeah, so I sent him a secondary email that was had the subject line, where is it? AD paid invoices from law firm. So you can see Sunday, this was a different email, a completely separate one. So Sunday, June 5th. Hey, well, this was from me. You will never guess what I just came across that I totally forgot about, I forgot I even had. Alan and Bubbles' fake attempts to pass off invoices for the cease and desist letters that they claim to have paid out to Duncan Lewis. Hang on. There we go. Never mind, I just came across Alan and Bubbles' fake attempts to pass off invoices for the cease and desist letters that they claim to have paid out to Duncan Lewis. If you recall, Iva was in charge of obtaining these garbage documents. I've included cover so-called work by the firm. I've included what covered so-called work by the firm from September 29th to, October 15th, I believe was the time frame. I've also included a screenshot that Bubbles passed off back from October 4th, where Duncan Lewis performed other imaginary legal work. I'm hoping this will be great evidence of some of the shit he has been up to. Let me know what you think. So this is where even I was still falling for, the richest man in Norway, Richie Rich. He's hired Duncan Lewis. Again, I'm busy with my own shit, not fucking looking into what Martin's doing. Now, bear in mind, guys, this is just after he got together with Helen, but roughly two weeks before he pulled his 180-degree fast stance on Claire, and all of a sudden, we're all pieces of shit for supporting or for not fucking supporting her for the last 10 months. Now we're pieces of shit because Martin's decided that he's going to support Claire. So we're all evil, traitors, rats, and trolls. Fuck off, Martin. Now, I'm going to make this smaller for a second. Now, some of this, I mean, he doesn't make any sense, but this is what I want to draw your attention to. Okay, you see the date? June 6, 1239. Whoop, no, I don't want to open mail. Okay, so Martin replies to me. June 6th, so the next day. Oh, damn. Whoops. Sorry, guys. Oh, damn. This is excellent. Well, here, I'll let you guys read it. Try and save my voice. I'm going to leave that up for a couple minutes. You guys read it? Write it down. I can't help you if you don't write it down. And then I'll be back in a minute or so. Because I want to read the good stuff. Thank you. All right. Excuse me. Yeah, I'm having a puff. Okay. So this is where I think he's just putting a lot of bullshit filler in. So he put in this screenshot. I just need to explain something so there's no misunderstanding. I posted this earlier. And he talks about Sandy. And what I'm trying to point out really has nothing to do with this comment of Sandy's at all. So he kind of goes off on a tangent. Now, again, I'm going to leave this up, folks. She's referring to this community post. So I must have upset her. Of course, I didn't mean to. I removed it. And it's not like I'm mad, irritated, or anything. What I see in the community post is someone who's had more than enough. And if I'm making it worse by repeating AD's nonsense, I'll stop. This is where it gets fucking good. Martin, lying sack of shit. Pick a story and stick with it. Oh, that's your problem because you haven't. You got so many contradicting stories all over the place. So, if I pull back, I'm not doing a Claire. I'll still be around, just not making more AD videos. I tend to do them in the style of AD saying dumb shit, followed by me being sarcastic. If you read her community post, then you'll probably see what I see. AD seems to have almost pushed her over the edge with his 15 arrest bullshit. So by repeating all his crap, I could be adding more stress. And that's the last thing I want to do. I'll be around like normal, but no more AD videos from me. How many times has Martin fucking said that? Or John Mortensen? I'll keep you updated about things, of course. Show up in chat if I'm awake too. This is the best part. Love this, Martin. Went off. There we go. P.S. I'm letting you know because I know you'll understand and we'll keep this between us. If it weren't for the whole Claire thing, I wouldn't have brought it up. Others will probably speculate, but that doesn't bother me. As long as you and TJ know, I'm good. I don't ghost my friends or let them down. I certainly won't make a video bitching about it, but you know how it is on YouTube. Yep. Yep. Martin has been fucking nasty. Oh, no, I'm not angry. I'm passionate. I'm not angry at all. Angry fucking stoner. Get the fuck out of here. So, yeah, there you go, guys. Martin's own fucking words. Hang on. Let me just. Oh, someone's going to say. I forgot about this down here at the bottom, right? Someone's going to say, are you going to wimp out like Martin 2 genetic code, etc.? If that comes up, just tell them I'm at the yearly gang stalking convention and that you receive daily brochures and PowerPoint presentations from me. Yeah, you're real fucking funny, Martin. You're a fucking piece of shit. Here we go. Best part. So this was June 6th, 2 weeks, roughly 2 weeks before he pulled that 180 degree fast fucking hard turn on his stance about Claire and all of us continuing down the path that he'd been on with us for 10 months. We're pieces of shit. We're evil. We're trolls. We're haters. We're rats. Fuck off, Martin. You're a fucking lying sack of fucking failure shit. Martin's own words. So if I pull back, I'm not doing a Claire. I'll still be around. Just not making any more AD videos. I tend to do them in the style of AD saying dumb shit, followed by me being sarcastic. So by repeating all this crap, I could be adding more stress, and that's the last thing I want to do. I'll be around like normal, but no more AD videos from me. I'll keep you updated about things, of course. Show up in chat if I'm awake too. P.S. I'm letting you know because I know you'll understand and we'll keep this between us. If it weren't for the whole Claire thing, I wouldn't have even brought it up. Others will speculate, but that doesn't bother me. As long as you and TJ know, I'm good. I don't ghost my friends or let them down, and I certainly won't make a video bitching about it. Fuck off, Martin. Fuck right off, you piece of fucking shit. Yep. I mean, let's just be clear. Martin and I were never friends. So I want to put that to rest. I've had a few people come to me and say that they had concerns about Martin for a long time, but didn't want to say anything to me because they thought I was friends with Martin. I would like to be very, very, very crystal fucking clear. Martin and I never were, never have been, obviously never will be friends. We communicated a few times through email about AD stuff, and that was fucking it. Yep, that's about it, eh? Fucking, what is my... I'm going to test you via pot smoke signals, puff, puff, pass, puff, puff, pass. Can you please answer in the form of a smoke signal? Yeah, well, don't we all? Yeah, just because the truth isn't pretty doesn't make us evil souls, traitors, rats, trolls. A lot of this, I think, honestly, and I could be very wrong. I'm not writing it down. That's it. You failed already, Puff Puff. Well, no, you can't fail because you're my favorite stoner student. I think a lot of this trying to, as I said, I mean, Martin has, he's done nothing except, I guess, stalk AD for well beyond the 3 years he's been stalking him on YouTube. That's what people that know him from way back say. I don't have any proof that I can put out there of that, so I'm just purely saying that from my speculation and standpoint. Who caught? I guess I'm a little lost here. I haven't really been. I'm lost. All right. I'm going to let you guys talk amongst yourselves because I'm just confused now more than I normally am. Hey, Dave, my Canadian buddy's here. All right. He brought the milk. I'm not sure I understand. Are you being called a stalker now, BTC? That's kind of what it looks like. Why would that be the case? I'm a little confused. Je suis confuse là. Now, one other major, major important thing that I need to clear up here, right here, right now. Y'all see what that is? That is a boot. That is not when I say what I say when I'm going to go out and about. That is a boot. I go out and about. A boot in front of you is a boot. This girl goes out and about. So let's just get that fucking clear once and for all. All right. Now, because again, actually, hold on a sec, guys. Uno momento. Talk amongst yourselves. Hey, Cassius, I'm not sure if you know that talk amongst yourselves. That was something a woman named Joan Rivers, who was a talk show host back in the 80s, quite the crazy character. Unfortunately, she's no longer with us, but that was one of the things she always said was like, talk amongst yourselves. I think she was like from Jersey, so she had like that New York accent, talk amongst yourselves. So just to be clear, I'm not trying to take that saying as mine. to make me a proven liar. That's Joan Rivers saying. Just like I never said seriously that the Chin Chin caricature I actually drew. So fuck up with your bullshit and your lame ass attempts to make me look bad. Holy fuck. Fucking pathetic. Oh yeah, give me a sec here, guys. I forgot what I was doing for a second. La 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 la.
You can tell that a lot of these true crime YouTubers, they've never thought for themselves in their entire life. You are like those dumbass puppies, you know? The ones that run around with their tongue hanging out of their mouth cross-eyed. You know, the puppy's cute, but it's still fucking stupid, you know?
That's right, Mr. Upchurch. Love it. Fucking love it.
We're now living in a society where it is okay to be stupid. I don't think it's ever okay to be stupid, because stupid things might happen, and to fix those stupid situations, it needs people who, you know, aren't stupid. Now, the people out there that don't like me and get irritated by me and stuff, I know what you're probably thinking. You're probably thinking, well, why the fuck you think you're so smart? It's actually the problem. I don't think I'm smart at all, but I'm starting to feel smart. I'll never understand, dude. Like, it's a common sense thing. What am I arguing with these other people for? The people I'm arguing with aren't smart enough to understand what's in front of their face. Literally, in front of their face. Yeah, the actual definition of literally. Not using it every other sentence.
Yep. Right in front of your face, people, and you either haven't come to that realization yet that this is really what the fuck is going on, or you're choosing not to see what's in front of your fucking face. So that's where we're at. So this is my community post from a couple days ago. Of course, Chuffs, denying all reality, continues to lie in cover for her best non-lawyering liar buddy, Claire Morgan. Oh, shit. Hang on. I forgot to do read more. Hang on. Give me a sec. I'll be right back. Talk amongst yourselves again for a minute. Bum, bum, bum. Wah, wah, wah. I failed. See, if I didn't smoke the pot, I would have done it properly. All right. Hang on a sec, guys. La 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 la. Right, close that. Open this. Yes, I'm talking to myself, everybody. All right. You've got the munchies, Pop Pop. Don't fuck you, you're starving. That's because you got the munchies. Did I tell you I got some minute? Kim laughed at me when I told her my newest flavor for this week, Puff Puff, is Glueberry OG. G-L-U-E berry. Not blueberry. Glueberry OG. Any type of OG strain of weed, I'm in. I'm in like Flynn. Write it down. Can't help you if you don't write it down. All right, let's try this again, guys. Take two. So, still the same community post, just now actually expanded. Helen Chafer, denying all reality, continues to lie and cover for her best non-lawyering liar buddy, Claire Morgan, by stating, and I quote this because this was in her community post, or it was in a comment. Sorry, it was a comment that she was very rude to Broken Arrow, who was very polite, very well-spoken in the questions asking about Claire. And Helen was fucking dismissive, of course, tippy-tapped around, didn't answer the question, and then the few handful of subs that her and Martin have left over there commenting decided to dogpile on Broken Arrow. Yeah, because that's a brilliant way of proving your point. So denying all reality continues to lie and cover for her best non-lawyering liar buddy, Claire Morgan, by stating, and I quote, another rumor when people accuse Claire of sharing confidential info with all and sundry. I haven't seen evidence of that happening, end quote. Claire should have never shown that portal to anyone, not one single person, maybe other than Frankie. Claire has severely breached confidentiality, ethics, and most of all, people's privacy protection. P.S. Do you even know that your best friend doesn't have an E at the end of Claire? Everywhere in her comments, she spells Claire with an E. That's a real good best friend. Real good best friend there. So what I'm going to do here now is I'm going to play it again. This is how Claire, in her own words, in her very, very own words, how Cohen Davis verified Claire Morgan as Claire Morgan, a person only. You are going to see with your own eyes and hear Claire in her own words. There was no education, no credentials of any kind were presented or verified. All she showed that Claire or Cohen Davis verified her with was a utility bill, passport photo as proof of address, letter of authorization from Frankie, and a fucking basic background check.
It just keeps going and going.
Look
and
at
going.
DT's in jail. Here
we are, look. Look at that. Here we are, look. See, that's my proof of address and my passport and everything where they checked me out to prove I was
checking
right
you
who I said
you.
I was.
Yeah, and you know, noticed that's the first things too before anything else went for. Which I would expect, yeah.
Yeah, before they even added me to this, they wouldn't,
they wouldn't add me
to the project manager. No, I have to have a letter of authority from Frankie saying that he gave permission for me to be involved in the case.
That's on his
and they went through all my, they did a police check, which obviously came up nothing. They did a police check. They had actually proof of my address, utility bill, a photo of my passport.
That's something else, eh? I've known AD that we all have fucking, what does he say, the records along with our arm? As far as I know, none of us have any criminal fucking records. So that's another instance of, you know, him putting on to us what really he's guilty of.
Yeah, no, and I for sure don't, because the solicitors have only just done a police check on me. I'm as clean as a whistle, not even a parking ticket.
Yep, you might be clean as a whistle right now, Claire. Pretty sure by the time this is all said and fucking done, you're not going to be fucking clean as a whistle no more. I hope you're fucking prosecuted for your bullshit. I really do. I really fucking do. Fucking goddamn. That's why this community fucking broke down and fucking crumbled. Yep, it doesn't prove that she's a lawyer in any way, shape, or form. It proves she's Claire Morgan, a fucking person. Clean as spit on a whistle. Yeah. So, hey, Amanda. So, that's what I got for today. Yep, it's absolutely crazy. They said, the more you want to keep lying about me, Martin fucking douchebag, fucking cocksucking, washed up, wannabe, never was, rock star, every time you fucking lie about me, I'm going to come back just as fucking hard, if not harder, with the fucking truth about you. And again, I'd like to ask the question for today. Do brown eyes change to blue as you grow older? I thought that only happened when you're a baby. A Claire Morgan candle looks great, but the wick disappears halfway down. You must be talking about the Glueberry OG strain, right? Yeah, guys, let's keep any insults, nasty name calling and shit minimal, please. Thank you kindly. My target has been Claire for the last fucking 10 months, Paul. Again, for the last time, I'm not going to explain this to you again. Martin Dehan has been trying to ruin my fucking reputation, ostracize me from this community, and I'm not going to fucking stand for it. I'm sorry if you don't like it. I'm sorry if you feel that it's letting AD win. Exposing the fucking truth and telling the truth, that's what this is about. The end by Jan. So with that being said, I'm going to leave that here. I think there's quite a bit of info. Again, actually, hang on before I go. I want to. So once again, guys, when I at the beginning of the stream, when I showed those credit cards, it's about Martin's BS. Fucking right it is, Lorak. Fucking sick and tired of Martin thinking he's absolutely nothing. He's been causing chaos and mayhem minimally since, well, he turned on his stance about Claire. But we're starting to see that his contradiction in his stories about Claire, like we saw, there's that picture that I put up that has him explaining on October 18th how he started the GoFundMe for Bam to stop harassing Claire because he knew she was everything she said then. But the problem is, Salty and I didn't even expose Claire in the fucking... When we came out and exposed Claire, we came out and exposed her about her fucking bolting and fucking off with no explanation in regards to Alan's copyright strikes falling off. We came to try and explain to a community why the fuck Alan's channel came back. We didn't even talk or show a blurred out portal until December. And for the last, December, January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August. Yes, I'm counting on my fingers, Kim. For the last 9 months, anytime Salty and I, the two, maybe three streams at most we've done in the 9 months when we have shown that portal, it was blurred out. All the voices except for Claire's was blurred out until recently. Had enough with people saying clan and clan that, had enough with people like Helen fucking Schaefer and Martin fucking Dehan lying, continuing to lie about this bullshit with Claire. Claire never submitted what she needed to submit to YouTube. And that's why YouTube reinstated anal. Claire Morgan never submitted to YouTube what she needed to submit. And that's why YouTube reinstated Alan Scam Chair Detective Pervy Fraud's channel. Claire Morgan was never a fucking lawyer ever in her fucking life. Ever. How many times have we heard that? Sandra got on and made a video where she said her friend Claire is a lawyer. This is not about the family at all, but I'm just trying to point out the different times where people, it's been spit out, oh, Claire has said she was a fucking lawyer, for fuck's sake. That stream apparently has been hidden, but it doesn't mean it's always hidden. Once it's there, you can delete it, just like Alan, and there's always still remnants of it. But Claire herself saying she was a fucking lawyer. So again, I'm going to put these screenshots, these links in the chat. This is the screenshot from Martin's stupid video from yesterday where he's got his apparent credit card. By all means, guys, don't believe me. Take that first link that's just the original screenshot. Do some checking yourself. You'll see the name, the date, the whatever, expiry date. That stuff is stamped on by a machine. There is no way that human error would misalign letters. It is so not symmetrical. It's fucking ridiculous. I love Amanda. She knows that. And she has such incredible long posts too. So well thought out. I love the way your brain fucking thinks. So
that's a wrap. What did you learn from that?
I think we learned a lot this evening. All right, guys. Happy rest of Monday, Tuesday, wherever you are in the world. You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here. So I'm gonna fight, gonna give it my all, gonna make you fall, gonna suck it to you. That's right, I'm the last one standing, and number one bites the dust. And number one bites, and number one bites, and number one bites the dust. And number one bites, and number one bites, and number one bites the dust. And number one bites, and number one bites, and number one bites the dust. And number one bites, and number one bites, and number one bites the dust. Gonna get to you, another one bites the dust.
Down the street, keep the people way down low. Ain't no sound but the sound of speed. Machine guns ready to go. Are you ready? Hey, are you ready for this? Are you hanging on the edge of your seat? Out of the doorway, the bullets rip to the sound of the beat. Yeah. Another one bites the dust.
Gun store.
Another one bites the dust.
Gun store.
And another one. And another one. Another one bites the dust. Hey.
Gang stalkers.
Hey. Gonna get you too. Another one bites the dust.
Gang stalkers. Gang stalkers. Gang stalkers. Stalkers. Gang stalkers. Gang stalkers.
Money. 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 Money, money, money. Money, money, money. Money, money, money.
Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust.
I was talking our channel live.
Another one bites the dust.
I'm just talking our channel live.
Another one bites the dust.
I'm just talking our channel live. I'm just talking our channel live.
Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust.
Another one bites the dust.